Hey everybody, it's Shelly, and let me tell you, this is going to be a longer video than my usual because I've been wanting to do this for several years. One of my most popular videos was how to set up an email with Constant Contact, and it is about time, 5 years later, that I do one again. So I'm looking at about 10 minutes. I'm not going to rush through this. So here we go. And basically, I'm going to take you online and show you how to use the new editor that Constant Contact has. They've made it really easy to use email. And if you're wondering why I'm even doing this, it's because email marketing has changed my business. Constant Contact has, I'm a local expert for them, so I'll give you that little footnote, but they have definitely transformed my marketing. I never have to really do much because I send out a regular communication, and that's why email marketing is so important. So I don't care who you're using, use somebody. I hope it's Constant Contact. I'll come at the end and tell you how to get a hold of me if you do want to give it a try or you do want to sign up because they have some specials. So let me take you online. We're going to go ahead and get started. And the reason I'm doing this is my YouTube channel, and I thought I would show you this. One of my most, actually, my most popular video was done 5 years ago with 30,000 views, how to use Constant Contact. And that's why I'm doing this today. So let me go ahead and get started. I am on my Constant Contact account right now. Where you would be, and this is my real live account, is on the home page, which are the various campaigns. You can see I just sent a St. Patrick's Day out this morning. And where we're going to start, of course, is create. Go to that big old create button. When that opens up, if you're using just the basic email package, you'll have that. If you have the email plus, you'll have the ability to do surveys and events. But today we're just talking about creating an email. I'll go ahead and click on the email icon. That will open up an option to select a very template. Now, some of you that sign up with me and have signed up in the past or are signing up today or in the future, they'll build you a custom template that matches your website. And they even give you 60 days to get me that website and they'll build it. But in the meantime, or if you don't have a website, there are hundreds of templates in here for you to select from. And you can go in and change the logo to yours and the images, which we're going to do in a minute. Now, right now, I am in what they call the legacy template area. You'll see right up at the top, there's a new editor, new templates, and I'm going to click on that because the new templates give me the ability to use the new editor. And in the new editor, my templates are mobile ready. If they create a custom template for you, it will be mobile ready as well. So here I can see I can view all the templates that are mobile ready and ready to go. I can select one, which I'm going to do, or I can preview. In this case, I'm selecting the basic newsletter. Now, with the basic newsletter, it's pulling what I have in there already, which of course is my springboard logo that I've already uploaded and created. It also has social media links, which we'll talk about in a moment, but I want to show you how to use the basic template. The first thing you'll see up at the top is where you're going to give it a name. So in this case, I'm going to put a star because that means it'll pop up at the top, and I usually use a date. And this is going to be a demo of Constant Contact new editor. We'll just call the template that, this particular newsletter that I create. And now when I'm in here, every time I hover, you'll notice I'm in a block. All these blocks can be changed, and how you change them is when you're hovering over, you'll notice they all have this little icon, which means you can move it around, click and drag to move, or they have the little gear. And if you click on the little gear, you can either change the color to anything you want, as you can see there, or if I click on the gear again, I can go in and trash this particular layout or block. I can even click duplicate, and there you see. And in this case, I'm going to go ahead and trash, and you'll see it goes away. So it's very easy to go in, change the color, which I'm going to go ahead and back and do on the color back to white. But you can just go in and click the cog and pretty much do what you want there. When you're in the template itself, you'll see that this is an image file. you'll see the arrows. And if it's an image file, I can make it bigger, I can make it smaller. And when I click inside the image, I can add a link. And this is where you'll go in and add your website or whatever you want. Not only that, it doesn't have to be just a web page. If you wanted to enter an email address so that somebody can click and send you an email, you can do that as well as bring in a document. It's a little more advanced, not that it's hard to do, you just click it and do it. But for now, we're going to kind of just stick with images right here. As I scroll down, again, I can click inside. My editor, looks a lot like Word, opens up, and I can go in and change anything I want in that block as far as what I see there. I can go in and delete it. I can go in and change the font to a larger size. We'll make this 18. This is bigger. I can enter a link if I'd like, and of course it's telling me what is the link, so I can maybe do the text to display, visit my website, and the link would be http springboardworks.com. And I could even test the link if I wanted to. And since this is a video and a demo, we're not going to do that. I can change the color of the text by hovering over it and changing it to pretty much anything I want. I can bold it, italics, kind of like a Word editor, like I said. So you can play around with that. And remember, you can't break anything. So you can go in, change this up, and even delete the newsletter when you want. You notice there's a title block right here. That's I'm going to trash that because I don't want to put that title there. So I just click the trash. And up above it, I didn't talk much about this, but this is basically who it's from. You can change that. You can give your subject line, and you can even have pre-header, which I suggest you do. This helps people know what the email is about. It goes above the subject line. So it just gives a little more information. There's even a block that you can click on that explains that. At any time you click preview, it's going to bring up the email, and it also saves it when you click preview, and it's going to show you what the email looks like. And we haven't done a lot yet, but you'll see I can look at it in desktop mode as well as mobile. How cool is that? I can look to see what my template email newsletter, excuse me, is going to look like. I can send myself a test email, which I strongly encourage you to do to see what it looks like on your PC or mobile, and before you send it out to your folks. All right, so here we are. I haven't even shown you the editor yet. I'm still showing you some of the navigation. You'll notice when you see this little bar, I can make that section bigger or smaller. I can go in and change, insert a different image, which I'll do right now. We're going to use the editor here in a minute. We'll just go ahead and put my old mug in there. I'm going to click insert, and there it is. And remember, when I see those blue arrows, I can make it bigger. I can make it smaller. Okay, I can even put a link behind it. And of course, I would put the link to, let's just say, Springboard again. We'll insert that. So now, when anybody gets my newsletter and clicks that image, there'll be a link behind it. Again, how I did that was I just clicked inside the picture, and that lets me do a link, replace it, trash it, or just say done. And then I'm going to make this text a little bigger. And again, when I'm in here, I can edit this. Check out my book. I'm just kind of making this up. If I want to put a link behind that, I can put my Amazon, if I can remember it, amazon.com/author/Shelley Roth. We're going to test a few of these. I can test them right here, but we're going to test them in the email itself. Notice it's underlined, so I know that's a link right there. I probably wouldn't do a link like that. I'd put it behind an image, or maybe even put a link after there. Again, it's just go to my special offers, and then we just put HTTP. We'll do ShelleyRoth.com, and then they can click on the calendar link. So now see the way that highlighted. So that's a link to my special offers. I'm going to even make that bigger. Kind of a mashup we're doing here. Doesn't look so great, but I'm getting the point across. All right. And if you want to get rid of like any of these, all you have to do again is go to the little cog and click the trash button, or duplicate it. Again, I don't want to get rid of that block just yet. Go to the trash and click delete, and boom, it's gone. Another thing while we're on the template, you can go in and add your name. Again, this is just a template that we picked, but if they build you a custom template and you have this information on your website, most likely they'll pull it and put it on there. The other cool thing is I can go in, and if I use a template or if they have my social media properties, I can delete Facebook if I don't have it, or I can edit. I have to give it my Facebook address, my Twitter address, my YouTube address. It doesn't know that. You have to give it. Okay, so again, and at the very bottom, if you're using an email service provider like Constant Contact, you must give people a way to unsubscribe. Very, very important, unsubscribe to your newsletter, because that is part of the Can Spam Act. You have to be able to let people get off of there. All right, so this is probably going to go almost 15 minutes because I wanted to show you everything. All right, so that is the navigation of the template and the build. Now, once we have our template that we want, I come over to these three boxes: build, images, and design. And I'm going to start with the easy one, design, because as you see, there's just a gray block. Well, guess what? On the new editor, I can select any of these backgrounds and it'll change it. We'll use the one you can see the best. Now my background is different. We're going to go ahead and close the backgrounds. But I also can change my headlines. See the way they're in that turquoise color? I can go in here and say, let's make that purple, or let's make that red. Or I can even click more colors and add my hex code, if you know it. That's kind of like a Pantene cone code, and it'll change that. Side note, you can use a tool like colorcop.net to figure out what your hex code is. I think I have a video on using ColorCop, and if I don't, I will make one. So that's how to go in and change your buttons and your headline. So the buttons, see the way it's gray? Visit our website. All I have to do again is click that, and I can change the color of the buttons as well as that little border that you see. All right. Now on the build side, let's go back to that. I can just drag anything over and add an image wherever I drop that. Okay, I can also drag text wherever I want to bring in text. I'll do it a few times and you see all that text now. Just remember, you can go in and you can trash that if you want to go in and say, nope, don't want all that text. And now I'm back to the original. So all you're doing is dragging and dropping. I also can go in and drag and drop another button. And there's another button. Again, if I want to delete it, I can click the little cog and get rid of it, but all you do is drag and drop. How do you change the words? Same thing. You click inside and you can change anything you want there. And we also, of course, can add that link, and I've shown you that a couple times, so we're not going to do that. Now, dividers are cool if you want to put some space in between stuff. You just drag this over wherever you want it, you see. And not only that, when you're inside of there, you can make it as big or as small as you want. You notice how much bigger it's getting when I do that? And even wider. I'm going to make it not as wide. We can make it smaller. See the lines moving? So you can fool around with this. Again, you're not going to break anything. Social media is just that. I drag this in, boom. It brings up social properties that I may or may not, quote, own. When I click inside that box, I can click, I can trash any of these or trash the whole thing. Let me bring it in again. And then I can go in and I can get rid of Facebook if that's not, oops, sorry, didn't want to do that. I can go in and edit any of these. You can see I can edit and give Facebook, or let's say I don't use Instagram, I click the trash button right there, I don't use Pinterest, so now I click insert and they're gone. And then of course I do video, weekly videos, most of you know me from that. You see I can just drag this and bring it over, and now I have two videos. I'm going to get rid of one, hit the trash button, and let's go ahead. I think I might have deleted them both. There's my video, and if I want to edit this, All I do is bring in a YouTube video link from my YouTube channel. It'll pull a thumbnail image. I can test the link here. And now I have my newsletter pretty much. Actually, let me go, since I'm on my YouTube channel, I'm going to go ahead and click this old video and add it there so you see what it does. So here's my video. I'm going to add the link from YouTube. I'm not going to test the link, but I am going to click insert, and boom, there's my video. People can play it when they get my newsletter. Now on the layouts, I don't do much of this. I usually pick a template I want, or I have Constant Contact build me a template. But if you wanted to, if I scroll down, I can bring over any of these layouts, and boom, there's what you see right there. You can build from the canned templates. You can even bring in a coupon if you want to and edit it. So when people get their newsletter, they'll see this particular block is a newsletter. On the images side of the house, all my images are already uploaded here. Happy Halloween and Happy New Year. And all again I do is if I want to bring an image, I just drag the image and there it is. When I click inside it, I can add a link to it. I can replace it. I can trash it. Let me show you that again. So let me say I'm bringing in my LinkedIn image. I click inside of it. I can trash it, add a link, replace it. And don't forget, I can make it bigger by clicking that. I'm going to go ahead and trash this so we have more room here. I'm going to move this over by clicking the bar. And when I click inside of the image itself, I think I went too fast. I confused it. So when you're on your newsletter where you see those little arrows, remember you can make anything smaller or larger. Okay, so we have our images, our design, and of course we covered our build. Now once I have my template going, again, when you click preview, it's going to give you the option to look at that template both on the PC as well as the desktop. So if I look at the mobile, I'm going to see exactly what this is going to look like. Again, it's kind of a hodgepodge right now, but I just wanted to show you some of these tools that you can use. The other thing to mention to you, let's get back to edit, is you have a library up at the top that not only has your images, but Constant Contact has a bunch of images you can use in there. Now, the beautiful thing about your email newsletter is you get reports. And I'm going to show you some actual reports of one of my emails in a moment. Your contacts are the contacts that you bring in to Constant Contact. So when I'm ready to, I can click continue. And I can keep this as a draft. I don't have to send it right away. I can schedule it for later by clicking that. And I can also select the lists that I want it to go to. You can have as many lists as you would like. So I can click send now or schedule for later. We're really not even going to do any of that. What I do want to show you is some of the reporting. So if I go into reporting, they're going to be some of the email came. Well, I'm going to take you to campaigns, so this will make more sense. I'm going to go ahead and pick something that went. We'll just pick this LinkedIn follow-up. We're just doing that. That was a class that I had. So if I click on that, I can make a copy of this so I never have to create it again. Actions are up at the top, but what I want to show you is on the reporting side of the house. I see the stats, how many opened it, how many clicked on it, and as I scroll down, I can see where did they click, and there were several links in there. People clicked on this link or that link. So go in, and when I say show you, it's not just going to show you numbers. If I go in and say, well, who clicked on which links in my email, it's going to show me the names of those folks, and that's the beautiful thing about using email with Constant Contact is I can see and save a list of anybody that clicked on a specific link inside of that email. Now I know this was very, very long. We're almost at 20 minutes, but I really, really feel it's important to run you through some of this. I've been promising to do this to myself and other people, make a current version of the new editor on Constant Contact. So I hope you got some good stuff. If you're ready to get started, they always have specials. I'm not sure when you're viewing this, but right now they have a 30% off. You might want to get a hold of me directly at sroth@shellyroth.com because they always have different specials to offer, and I can get you started both on a trial, or if you're ready to get going, They always have specials that I could tell you about. And the cool thing is, they'll create a free custom template for you that matches your website. That means they'll build it. You don't even have to worry about picking a template that's already created. Unlimited support if you need help, you call them, and a money back guarantee after 30 days. So get a hold of me. The easiest way to go to shellyroth.com, see if I have any email marketing classes coming up soon. And we can meet in person and sign you up there. So give me a shout. Let me know how I can help you. Have a great day, and we'll see you next time.